So, Mr. Kent, we have here a population of Capeweed. And it's scattered all through the garden, our biodiversity garden. And you can see it stretches all the way up there as well. Now, I quite like this flower because you can see there's definitely some pollinators that come. There's a bee, is it flying around, coming and getting some pollen. And this basically promotes a nice healthy ecosystem in our biodiversity garden, even though it is called the Cape Weed and it grows a bit like a weed.
Is it the same amount here as it was last year, or do you think it's changed?
Well, it feels like there's more this year, but I don't know, how do you think we can maybe check and see? What you doing there, Mr. Kent?
I'm counting. 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 101.
Mr. Kent.
501,
502, 503. Mr. Kent.
Yes.
I really actually need to get home. But it's taken you like half an hour just to get to 500. And there's a lot more field here for you to count. I don't know if it's going to work.
So how would you do it?
Well.
So there's a method, Mr. Kent, that we can use called sampling. And in this case, we're going to use something called quadrat sampling. Now, I need to actually get you a quadrat so you can see what I'm talking about.
Nice picture frame, Dr. Daru.
Thank you. So, this is a quadrat, and it's a method we can use, or a tool that we can use as biologists, to actually quickly get some information without having to do what you were trying to do, and that's count every single individual. So what we do is we place a quadrat pretty randomly in the field of Capeweed, and we count how many individuals are in that particular area. And then we repeat that maybe a couple of times to improve the reliability. And we can then use this formula. And the formula is really great, it's very simple. N is the total population, that's what we're trying to find out. Little n is standing for the number in the quad that we count, or the average number if we've done many multiple quads. A is the total area, that's going to take some working out, I'm afraid. And little a is the area of the quad that you can just use a ruler for and measure how big your quad is. So in this case, the quad's 50 centimeters by 50 centimeters, and that's 0.5 times 0.5. That's 0.25 meters squared.
What happens, Mr. Kent, if we end up with no flowers in our quad?
Then we record a zero.
Let me try again.
You have to sometimes look carefully. That is, in fact, a one, a two, a three, a four, a five, a six, a seven. Are we counting the flowers, Mr. Kent, or are we counting the plants?
I think we should count the plants.
It does make more sense to count the plants rather than the flowers. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so Mr. Kent, how do you decide where to place this quad that I've given you?
Well, it's going to be random, right?
Yeah.
So if I spin around, that's random, isn't it?
I would say that's pretty random, yes.
The most difficult thing to do with this method is to actually work out what the area is that you are working out the population of. So as you can see here, this area that we are in is, it's not exactly a square or a rectangle. It's made up of many different little shapes put together to create this lovely biodiversity garden. So what you need to do is work out the size of that particular section. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 79, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 129, 130, 131 rectangle that I've measured, you have the area, and then you add up each of the sections that you measure independently, add those together to get the total area.
Mr. Kent, he gets bored with mundane tasks.
Each time that we repeated that randomly. Now what we're going to do with this is we're going to calculate the average number of plants that we counted per quote. And my maths is excellent. I know offhand, just by looking at those numbers, that the average is... the average is 6 per quote.
Quick maths.
Thank you. So, don't know the total number. We do know the number in each quote. At the moment, we're sitting with an average of 6. So we can substitute it with 6 over there. We do know the area of the quote. That's 0.25 meters squared. And thanks to some excellent measurements by Mr. Kent, we do know, and we calculated, the total area of the biodiversity garden field where we're counting these cape weeds is, what was it? It was 265 meters squared.
When answering this question, a mistake that lots of people make is to not show they're working properly. So when we do these calculations, this is our formula. Now with a calculation, you always, 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 I made that point, always write down the formula first. So step one, big N equals little n times big A over little a. That's gonna get you a mark straight away. Next step then is we need to substitute in our numbers. So remember, little n was 6, big A was 265, and little a was 0.25 meters squared. Then plug it into your calculator, write down your answer, and again, there's no units, but is what are we talking about? 6,360 cape weeds. Each of these steps is going to get you a mark. It's important to write them out in case you make a mistake entering it, you've still got those marks there. So always show you're working, write it out like this, step by step, including what it is that you're talking about at the end.
So, after a very exciting data collection, we collected 8 samples before Mr. Kent started being really silly again, and I had to stop him.
Absolutely.